Greetings everyone, welcome to the 15th episode of Churches of Wales Season 1. In this series, I take a look at buildings part of the church in Wales and covenanted churches in Wales. In the last episode, I looked at churches that are situated between the towns of Brecon and Targarth to Crickhowell, where I saw many beautiful buildings in settlements like Cantreff, Clangors, and more. In this episode, I will look at churches that follow the county boundary from the southeast to the southwest, and this is the final episode in the series where I will look at churches in the historic county of Breconshire. I am Fabian Musto, and I present you the final episode of the first season of Churches of Wales. In order to find these churches, I will use the Ordnance Survey map on Geograph as my reference for spotting church symbols, from maps of the 1920s, to maps of the 2010s and 20s. I apologize if some of my pronunciations of these place names are incorrect, since I am not a Welsh speaker. The first place I am at is situated west from the county boundary with Breconshire and Monmouthshire, and this is dedicated to a local early Celtic saint from the 6th century AD, who lived by the well southwest from the church. The site became a place of pilgrimage after he was murdered, and the church was founded with the offerings of pilgrims in 1060. This was built on the site of a cell church the patron saint built in his lifetime, and his shrine is in the west chapel of the church. The present church building mainly dates from the 14th and 15th century, although the font dates from the 11th century, and most of the pre-Reformation fixtures survive, such as the chancel rood screen and loft of around 1500. There are many wall paintings from the 17th to 18th century in the nave, such as the Stuart Royal Arms in the north wall, probably of James I of England, and the Ten Commandments in the south wall. The west wall depicts a skeleton holding an hourglass, spade and knife, and this may date from the 17th century or earlier. The church is situated south of the Black Mountains, and was carefully restored by this architect from 1908 to 1909. The church was Grade 1 listed in July 1963. 4 miles north from Crickhowell is a former Calvinistic Methodist chapel, built as a chapel of ease in the 16th century. That was abandoned by the mid-19th century, when it was converted into a nonconformist chapel in 1880. The east window, south door, roof and seating were installed in that year, and the chapel closed for worship in the late 20th century, when it was converted into an outdoor activity center for the King's School, Worcester. Some 3 miles south from there is St. Peter's Church, situated east from the Red Lion Public House. This was consecrated in 1060 by this bishop, and the settlement was known as this name in the Roman Empire, which is Welsh for region for the yew tree. The churchyard is home to 6 yew trees, and the yew tree north from the nave may be 2,000 years old. The church plan consists of a nave, chancel, south aisle and vestry, and mainly dates from the late 15th century. The west bell tower dates from that time, and the church was restored in 1868, 1883, and 1897. The church was Grade 2 star listed in July 1963, and west from there is the old Calvinistic Methodist chapel, built of brick in 1881. The Penoul Chapel is now a private house. 1.5 miles south from that village is another village, and this has a church dedicated to Saint Keen, who lived in the 5th century AD. The church has origins to the 15th century or earlier, and was remodeled later on that century. The North Island Chapel were built during the remodel work, although they were built as the nave and chancel. This was restored in 1863 and 1894, and the building was Grade 2 star listed in July 1963. South from the church is an old Calvinistic Methodist chapel, built around 1820. This closed for worship in the 20th century, and is now a private house. 1 mile south from there is a former Baptist chapel, situated west of the River Usk and south of the A40 road. Built in 1863, This was replaced by a new building from 1884. The town of Crickhowell is on the north bank of the River Usk, and there is a Baptist church of 1840 on Bridge Street. Built in the simple round-headed and sub-classical style, the chapel was Grade II listed in December 1985 and closed for worship in early 2016, when it was converted into a private residence. Situated opposite the castle ruins is an English Presbyterian church, built as a Calvinistic Methodist chapel in 1828. This replaced an earlier chapel from 1807, and is still in use as a place of worship, although it does not have listed status as of March 2023. The parish church of St. Edmund was established in 1303, and this is the only church in Wales dedicated to this patron saint, who was regarded as a patron saint of England during the Middle Ages. The church plan consists of a nave and chancel with north and south aisles, transepts and northeast chapel, although the aisles were demolished in 1765 and replaced in 1826 and 1835. The church was restored by J. L. Pearson in 1868, and Nicholson and Son restored the chancel from 1894 to 97. They repaired the church roofs during this time, and they retained two recumbent medieval effigies in the chancel. The first effigy of 1287 is situated in the south recess, which depicts a man with broken limbs, and the second effigy depicts his wife in the north recess, dating from the late 1320s. She established the parish church in Crickhowell in 1302, and she is portrayed with no hands in a reference to a local legend. There are recumbent alabaster figures in the chancel from 1690, depicting Sir John and Lady Joan Herbert, and the perpendicular Gothic style screen and reredos dates from 1934, built by this architect who installed the stone reredos at Brecon Cathedral in the same year. The parish church, complete with a crossing tower with octagonal brooch spire, was Grade II star listed in July 1963, and east of the churchyard is a former English Wesleyan chapel from 1851, situated at the corner of Tower Street. Built on the site of an earlier chapel from around 1800, this Gothic-style building closed for worship in the 1960s, when it was subsequently converted into a holiday home. Placed by the A40 road is the Roman Catholic Church of St. Joseph, built in 1934. The interior has stained glass by David Pearl in the sanctuary, dating from 1978, and the church closed for worship in 2012. A mile south of Crickhowell is the village and community of Clan Gattock, situated on the south bank of the River Usk. The parish church has origins to the 6th century AD, presumably established by the patron saint who was alive at this time. The west bell tower of three stages dates from the 16th century, built on the site of an earlier tower from the 12th century, and the building consists of a double nave and chancel plan, although the north nave is the north aisle and the north chancel is the vestry. The church walls were substantially rebuilt in 1719 and from 1785 to 87, the latter work included the replacement of the double-naved roof with the present roof. The building was restored in 1843 and 1886, and the church was Grade II star listed in July 1963. A third of a mile south from the church is the Congregational Independent Chapel, built in 1835 on land given by Sir Joseph Bailey of Glanusk Park. There was an earlier independent chapel in the village from 1768, situated south from the present chapel. The simple Gothic-style building was Grade II listed in October 1998, and the Bethesda Chapel is still in use as a place of worship as of April 2023. A mile northwest from Clan Gattock is a former mission church, presumably built in the late 19th century. The building was substantially modified into a private house around the late 20th century. Southeast from Cantref Reservoir is the site of a church by the A470 road, built in 1864 of the simple Gothic style. The building was photographed by Clive Bevan in 1993, which shows it in a dilapidated state. This photograph of the gutted interior was taken in the same year, and a proposal for conversion to a private dwelling was made during this time, although the structure was demolished by the 2000s. Here is St. Mary Parish Church in this village and community, built around the early 15th century. The church has origins to the 12th century, and there was a root screen of the 15th century in the church, removed in the 1650s during the Commonwealth period. The West Bell Tower dates from the late 15th or early 16th century, and the church was restored in 1882, with the chancel roof and font of the 16th century left intact. This was Grade 2 star listed in June 1962. Southwest from the church is the Calvinistic Methodist Chapel, first built in 1808, rebuilt in 1847 and rebuilt again in 1900. The Penuel Chapel closed for worship in the late 20th century. 2 miles southwest from that village is an independent chapel, first built in 1797 and rebuilt in 1854. The present building was built in the vernacular style in 1928. 2.5 miles south from that chapel is the southernmost settlement in Powys, and the village church of St. John the Evangelist was built around 1930. The church is situated north of this river, and the church does not have listed status as of April 2023. 5 miles northwest is this village, which has a church by the former Neath and Brecon Railway. The present building preceded an earlier church from 1799, which presumably replaced a medieval church, and the nave was built in 1885 with the west end extended by J. Cook Rees of Neath from 1913 to 14. The chancel was built in 1905, and the majority of the church fixtures dates from the 20th century. The Moriah Baptist Church is east from the church, and this was built in 1910. This replaced an earlier chapel from 1892, and the chapel closed as a place of worship by the 2000s. Placed by this river is the town of Ystradgynlais, the second largest town in Powys with a population of 8,270 at the 2021 census. The community has many religious buildings, although two of them has listed status as of April 2023, such as the former Sardis Independent Chapel of 1861 by Thomas of Landora. This building replaced an earlier chapel from 1841, and that chapel replaced the first chapel of 1832 on the same site. The chapel was extended in 1887, with the schoolroom added in 1926 and they received Grade 2 listed status in March 2000. The building was sold by Newport-based Paul Foch Auctions in January 2023. Placed by Commercial Street is the Tabernacle Chapel, a Calvinistic Methodist chapel that was built in the sub-classical style in 1890. This stone building still houses a place of worship many decades later, and further south from Commercial Street is Station Road, where there was a Baptist church that served as a place of worship from 1913 to 2014. The English Congregational Church on Commercial Street was built in 1907, and 4 local people laid the foundation stone at the site, including the minister of the Sardis Chapel at the time. The parish church of St. Kinog in Ystradgynlais was built to the designs of Benjamin Ferry of London from 1858 to 61, and this was built on the site of a medieval church. The old church was visited by Theophilus Jones in the 1800s, who described it as low, dark and too small for the parish, and the interior had a gallery in the nave from 1743. The church plan consists of a nave, chancel and lean-to aisles, and the west end of the nave was rebuilt in 1960. The stained glass in the windows were installed in the 20th century, and the interior was refurbished in 2005. The patron saint of the old church was believed to be Saint Mary, and the new church was consecrated to Saint Kinog in December 1861. The dedication to this patron saint was unknown for several decades, thus locals referenced to Theophilus Jones's claim to this saint that appeared on the 1900 Ordnance Survey map, but the incumbent vicar in 1914 discovered the patron saint was Saint Kinog, when he dug out the details of the first service from 1861. Southwest of the parish church is the Sacred Heart Roman Catholic Church, built in 1938, and opened for worship on 22nd of January 1939. The interior was refurbished in 1971, when the stained glass were installed in the 3 east and west windows, and the sanctuary was reordered at this time. Placed by the B4599 road is the Hope Apostolic Church, built in 1990 on the site of an earlier church from 1927. This is still in use as a place of worship, along with the Baptist Church half a mile north from the Hope Church. This was built in 1888 on the site of an earlier chapel from 1848, and the adjacent schoolroom was built in 1905. There was an English Baptist church in the town by the B4599 road, and this was built as a Welsh Congregational Independent Chapel in 1911. The Baptists purchased the building in 1946, and it subsequently housed the Bethany Chapel for 4 decades until it closed as a place of worship in 1990. The building was demolished some years later. Southwest of the town is the site of St. John's Mission Church, built in 1928, and housed a place of worship for several decades. The site was sold for redevelopment in 2009 and was demolished in October 2012. There is one church in this area of Ystradgynlais that remains intact. This is the Calvinistic Methodist Chapel of 1912. The entrance was flanked by conifers before they were removed in mid-2021. Some 2 miles west from the town is the Bethel Independent Chapel, built in 1925 on the site of an earlier chapel from 1861. The first chapel was built by Thomas Griffiths, and the present chapel closed for worship in 2010, the year when these photographs of the interior were taken. The building was Grade 2 listed in March 2000. North from the Bethel Chapel is a Calvinistic Methodist chapel, first built in 1851 and demolished in 1933. Replaced by the present building of 1935 in the Italianate and arts and craft style. Half a mile northwest is a former Baptist chapel from 1930, which held its first service on 1st of January 1931. This closed as a place of worship in 2010. The Beulah Baptist Chapel by the A4068 road was built in 1860, replacing an earlier chapel from 1834. The subclassical style building was modified in 1903, and across the aforementioned road is the vestry from 1893. A mile northwest is the Ebenezer Independent Chapel, built from December 1892 to 93. The chapel held their first service on 27th of June 1894, and this housed a place of worship for several decades. These interior photographs were taken in 2010. The site of St. Peter's Church was situated by the Ebenezer Chapel, built as a workshop in the mid-19th century before it was converted into a religious building in 1858. It closed for worship at some point in the late 19th century, then reopened from 1911 to 38, and it was demolished in the 1960s. A mile north from Ystradgynlais is a Calvinistic Methodist chapel, first built in 1806, rebuilt in 1824 and rebuilt again in 1858. The entrance porch was added in 1953. There was an independent chapel by the B4599 road, built in 1910 on the site of an earlier chapel from 1859. This housed a place of worship for many decades, until it closed in 2006 when the building was demolished to make way for a private house. The Moriah Calvinistic Methodist Chapel by the B4599 road was built in the subclassical and Italianate style, which opened for worship in April 1906. The chapel closed in 1980 due to declining congregation, and it was demolished in June 1991. The Moriah Chapel succeeded an earlier chapel by the A4067 road, built in 1850 as a Calvinistic Methodist chapel and Sunday school room. This was converted into a private house after it closed for worship in 1906. The building to my right is the Bethlehem Independent Chapel, built in 1861 in the simple round-headed style. The Sunday schoolroom adjacent to the chapel was presumably built in the same year, and the chapel closed for worship in the 2000s. The village of Abercrave has a Baptist church by the A4067 road, built from 1899 to 1900. The church was in use as a place of worship until 1991, and was later converted into a private house. The independent chapel of 1900 was in use as a place of worship for many decades, and they held their last service on 26th of May 2011. The building was sold afterwards, and these photographs from the late 2010s show the gutted interior when it was up for sale again. Here is the site of the Calvinistic Methodist Chapel in Abercrave, built by this architect from Birchgrove in 1897. The building also closed for worship in the early 20th century, although unlike the previous two chapels, the building was demolished in July 2007. The chapel churchyard remains intact 16 years later. The Church of St. David is situated by the A4067 road, built from 1911-12 to the designs of J. Cook Rees of Neath. The building plan consists of a nave, chancel, lean-to north vestry and south organ chamber. The stained glass in the building was installed by Powys in 1951, with the exception of a memorial window to the Reverend W. Edward Jones, vicar of Abercrave from 1935 until his passing in 1971. The church closed for worship in April 2016, and was sold as a private house in the early 2020s. Northeast from the church is an independent chapel, built in 1829 on the site of an earlier chapel from 1774. The building has been altered in recent years, but the Georgian-era building has seen little change since 1829. East from there is another chapel with Georgian-era origins, built in 1834 on the site of an earlier chapel from 1809. The interior may have been designed by Thomas of Landora in 1874, and the chapel closed for worship in the summer of 2011. The building is now a private house. 2 miles north is the Church of St. John the Baptist, built from 1892-93 near the site of an earlier church. The earlier building was built in 1840, and this presumably replaced a medieval church on the site. This was demolished in the early 20th century. The church was originally dedicated to this 6th century saint, which is shown on the 1900 Ordnance Survey map, but it was rededicated to St. John the Baptist in the mid-1960s. Some 6 miles northeast is the parish church in this village and community, situated by the A4067 road to Devinoc. Built in 1882 to the designs of John Fowler of Brecon and Ewan Christian of London, this replaced an earlier church that is not on the same site as the new church. The church is dedicated to this saint, and the stained glass in the east window were installed in 1924. Northwest from the church is a former Calvinistic Methodist chapel, built around 1830 with an attached house from 1899. The chapel was converted into the vestry and schoolroom the same year, since a new chapel was built several yards south. This is still in use as a place of worship, although it does not have listed status compared to the old chapel, which was Grade 2 listed in May 2001. The last building I will look at in this episode is an independent chapel from 1844, which replaced an earlier chapel from 1742 on the same site. The interior was renovated in 1876, the year when most of the present fittings were installed, and the gallery was removed in 1939. This was Grade 2 listed in October 1990. I am standing south of the chapel to end this episode, the last episode in the series where I will look at churches in the historic county of Breconshire, and with the three historic counties of Montgomeryshire, Radnorshire and Breconshire reviewed, this brings an end to Churches of Wales Season 1, Powys. I enjoyed looking at the many religious buildings in the county of Powys, as well as the religious buildings I looked at in Breconshire from episodes 11 to 15. It has been a privilege to have worked on this season, and I will consider working on another season of Churches of Wales.